this particular area.
Yeah.
But if in Accra you want a good place, it will not be in the city.
This is the middle of the city.
So this is, I mean, to get a plot is it would even be, would mean that you have to buy an old building.
Oh.
Crash it.
Because these people here, the Niagara Hotel, and they are selling the hotel for $4.5 million.
They're just a small hotel.
Yeah.
So that's a key area.
$4.5 million.
It's an old hotel.
Old, yeah, really old. So,
if but it's the plot. Where the plot is, is key. It's key.
But for someone with $4.5 million or $5 million, $6 million, do you recommend them to buy it? Or
do you have space around it? I don't know if they have enough space for future development.
They have a little bit behind it, but not big. Okay, just
because
small.
If I have $4 million, $6 million, then maybe I look for plot.
This is what I also thought. Because you can build beautiful hotels.
Yes, you can build that according to, because this is an old one. You must be very intelligent to convert it to something that is profitable. You must know what you're doing.
What to do,
before you.
So $4.5 million, don't do it.
If you're very some people know what they want.
Yeah.
You know, so if you're an expert in the industry, I'm sure they will know what to do. But I don't have that eye. So what I have is maybe I get a you know, an area that I think is good and maybe develop it myself. I'm not sure I have that kind of expertise to compete.
Yeah, because it's really old.
Yes. So now your cables, your pipes, you're gonna have to do a lot of major renovations. So what are you paying for, the land or the building? You know, so if it's the land, I'm sure $1 million you should be able to pay the price.
Good place, huh?
Yes.
But $1 million for a land?
Yeah, sure.
Here? This price here?
I'm sure.
So
and that car they will take from you.
So $1 million.
Yes.
Really expensive.
A price expensive. Especially the areas that seem to have some bit of development. This is a key area.
Okay.
Campanet is a key area. Rage. This is a major commercial area. You are going to Central Accra.
No.
Yes. If you go here, you go through Makola. You can pass it.
Let's do this.
Go to Makola, you see. You go to get a lamp there, you must have money.
Yeah? So, but I didn't expect it to be this expensive over here.
No, I know land is expensive. Here.
Yeah.
Where you get moderate land is when you go to outside. You're going to Amasama. Where the land is not service, means the roads are not good, maybe the electricity is not there, water. Then more or less like a farmland.
Yeah.
Then you can get 5,000, you know.
But not this area.
20. No, this area no.
And what about Pram? Because a lot of people talk about Pram.
A lot of people are going to Pram too. You can see that, yes. A lot of people from Pram to Sege to, you know, that stretch, it's a good area.
Good area?
Yes,
yeah.
If you get good people to deal with, it's good.
And what can you tell us about Accra for the people that are coming new over here for the first time? What can you tell us about this? So, is there some things that we need to be careful?
How much are you going to pay me? Alright. Okay. I know. See, this, I think there should be some fundamentals that should be understood. Which are, listen, this Africa is for all of us.
Yeah.
Whether you were born here, or anybody who looks like you looks like me, I think we must establish that fact. Whether we want to live on the continent or not, that's not the case. But we should know that this is for us.
Yeah.
It's for us. And we must take that ownership.
Yes.
Sometimes you meet people and we are trying to establish whether Africa is for them or not. I think that should not be in the discussion at all. This is for us.
Yeah.
Therefore, what can I do if I have to own something here? If I don't want to own anything here, no problem. But maybe let me visit. Because there's a lot of wrong data on Africa. And until somebody, especially you have come here, you have seen it. Nobody can use it against you anymore.
Exactly.
You know, they can show you, I'm sure, growing up, you heard all kind of stories on Africa.
Yeah.
And much of it were not good stories.
Yeah.
But now you have come, you have seen the people, you have seen the good side, not so good side. Now you can make your own judgment.
Exactly.
But it is your heritage.
Exactly.
And therefore, if the Chinese want to come here, the Europeans want to come here, the Indians, some of them have been here for centuries. Some of them are Africans actually. They were born here, they have their documents.
Yeah.
And so Accra is good.
But do you because right now there is an thing that black diaspora, there are some YouTubers that are cursing the black diaspora and say they are not welcome, they need to stay away, they are not Africans.
who can tell anybody to stay away? Stay away from Ghana or from Nigeria? Nobody can.
Exactly.
As a matter of fact, why would the president, Nana Addo, say that year of return? And I remember 100 and something African diasporans were given citizenship. They went through their own processes.
Mm.
And there are other African countries that are even giving or considering or giving citizenship. There's one DNA test. So nobody can tell you that, stay away. Who has that power?
Exactly. But you, what do you want? As a Ghanaian, what do you want?
But who, if you go to do the test now, I don't know whether you are from you are my 100 year distant cousin.
Exactly.
We don't know.
Exactly.
So how can I tell you that? Go.
Exactly.
You can only work out.
Exactly.
There are people who are not informed. There are people who don't know much.
Exactly.
So they can say all that. They think it's comedy. It's not comedy.
Exactly.
This is human life. This is destiny. This is heritage. So nobody has the right. The least that others can say is come. That's all.
Exactly.
We know that not everybody will be ready in terms of the information, the conditioning, because it has a lot to do with what you know, actually. Exactly. African Americans, Caribbeans, any African diaspora, I know that those who are very comfortable to come to Africa are those who have some quality data on Africa. Those who have been much more misinformed, they don't want to do it.
Yeah.
I expect, even there are people who were born here, who moved to America, because of the data they have, they don't want to do it. They don't want to have anything to do with Ghana.
Exactly.
You have met Ghanaians who will never come here to live in Ghana. Who will tell you what are you going to do in Ghana? It's more of what you know. That's the fact.
Yeah.
It's more of what you know about Ghana, about Africa.
Exactly. I have a friend in Netherlands.
Yes.
And he is Ghanaian. When I went to bring my kids to cut their hair, we talked about it. And I also told him, I asked him that, you know, why you are not in Ghana, why you're not going in Ghana? It's a really nice place, you know. This guy went in discussion and he also said, what are you going to do in Ghana?
That's
you
right.
You Caribbean people think that you can go to Ghana and change things.
This is we are going through Makula now. This is a key market area.
And now, what's the name of this one?
This is Accra Central Market. Makula, if you have heard of Makula, it's around here.
Makula
is a major, yes. So today is Sunday, but we are still
very busy.
Very busy here. Very busy. There are other West African countries. There are lorry stations out here. You can pick up from here to Lagos, to other areas. So these are all old settings. You know, if you are here on Monday morning or Saturdays, you can move. Yeah, it's a major. The people with money, a lot of them
are here.
Yes. If you're looking for people who can just show you,
yeah,
there are major. So Africa you can be in Africa and not understand Africa.
Yeah.
You can speak African language and dress African and still not know Africa.
Yeah.
Majority of our people don't have any strong data on Africa.
Yeah, man.
So you have to be constructively taught to understand Africa, even as an African.
Yeah.
Even if you're born here. That's why somebody would say that I just need a visa and move out of Ghana.
Yeah.
Because he can see.
Exactly.
He doesn't understand the system. You must understand what works here. Most people want to superimpose, I dare say, the white system.
Mm.
And they use it as standard for us to work. It does not work.
Exactly.
And so if you're here and all that you understand is how the world, how the Western especially, people have branded Africa. You can be in Ghana and still think through that worldview. And once you think through that worldview, that worldview is that Africa is sick, Africa is poor, Africa is backward, Africa has nothing, Africans have never achieved anything. That worldview is taught in our religious institutions, it's taught even in our government, it's taught in our schools. So majority of Africans have grown up thinking that they are disadvantaged and the rest of the world is advantaged. They are disadvantaged, they are underdeveloped, and the rest of the world is developed. It's not true.
No, it's not true. It's not
Can you imagine the West, where people don't have access to credit? If you don't have access to credit,
you are
to
done.
Buy a house,
you're done.
Car, go to school, who are you?
Nothing.
Nothing.
You're nothing.
Africa, how many people have access to credit?
Exactly.
What cost?
Exactly.
So
exactly.
The only difference is the
system.
Yes, it's the system.
Yeah.
And that system is even enslaving.
Yeah.
Because how do you bond somebody to own a house for 30 years?
Yeah.
You pay a house for 30 years.
You're
how long are you going to live?
Yeah, and you know what it is, that when you take a mortgage in diaspora, America, Caribbean, don't
give... It's tantamount to market. Yes, if you go inside, you see. All kind of people start their own businesses anyway, anyhow. Majority of our people start businesses. They trade. And they see money. Back to your question, you were asking me about what do I think about the diaspora is coming.
Yeah.
I think it's a must.
Yeah.
And it's a call.
It's a must and a call. And
yes, we are treated the same anywhere.
Yeah.
If I travel anywhere in the world, it's the same disrespectfulness towards us. So, in their head, we are one people.
Yeah.
If I go to China with you, they will not know.
Exactly.
Whether you are born in Ghana or Nigeria or you're born in
Caribbean,
in America. Or
So
they think that we are Africans. Yeah. And we are all Africans.
Yeah, we are.
And as a matter of fact, we are the majority. The world's tribe. Probably more than 2 billion people.
Yeah.
And yet, somebody is telling us that we are nothing.
Yeah.
So it's the information.
Yeah.
It's the information. And so, the good thing is that people are seeing it.
Yeah.
This is the old story, Accra Central. This is the old business. It still runs.
This one?
Yes, yes.
It's huge.
It's huge. Try to drive if I can make sense to you.
So,
yes.
Huge.
There are people who know here, they'll be able to tell you better things.
Yeah.
I drive. I think there is a Jamestown somewhere here.
Jamestown. This part of Ghana, I didn't been here.
You have not been here. This is the sea.
Oh, this is the sea.
Yeah, this is the sea. This is the sea. We will go through the Independence Square.
Yeah, there I've been.
Yes, you have been there.
Yeah.
So if you go back, you will see some old settings. There are lots of things. You can come and, take time, go there. They will show you a lot of things. I think this is Bank of Ghana or something.
Ghana.
Asia Bank.
Central Bank.
Central Bank. Yes.
Beautiful building.
This is the court. One of the courts. This is Kwame Nkrumah Mausoleum. Somewhere here. This is it, yes. You see the icon there? The structure there.
Yeah.
Yes.
What is this?
Kwame Nkrumah Mausoleum. That's where the things about Kwame Nkrumah, his body is kept there, his picture is here. So you should, Dr. Nkrumah. You should visit.
Yeah, and I can just go inside and visit.
Yes, they pay. Yes, visit.
Okay.
You pay, they move you around. It's a mausoleum. This is the cultural center. Art center.
Art center. Yes.
Art center.
Oh yeah.
Where
yeah,
they sell a lot of the artifacts.
Yeah, I saw a YouTuber.
Okay.
Checking this.
Yes, so there's a lot around where you are living.
Yeah.
This is new. Okay. Let's see. So this is one of the courthouse. It's actually, this is the government area, ministries.
Yeah. Yeah.
So this is a structure for Ministry of Agriculture. You go here, you will see Ministry of Education.
You can see the sea.
Yeah, you can see the sea. There's a lot, but we have no choice than to make sure that in our lifetime we can change the story.
Exactly.
Yes.
Like yesterday, I was in a live stream, and there was a lady.
Yes.
And this lady was talking about, she's from Africa.
Okay.
She was talking about how the diaspora are not welcome, they should stay away.
She told you?
Yeah, she was telling in the live stream, the host of the live stream.
Wow.
Yeah, so the lady said, we are not welcome, we are not African, and we should stay away because now that the Africans have built Africa, we want to come and those kind of things, you know.
It's an African woman?
It's an African woman.
And she lives in Ghana?
And she lives in UK now.
And she's doing that?
Yeah. Yeah,
what's the level of understanding?
What is happening is that she discouraged a lot of people from coming. People that will say, yeah, I won't come because if I'm not welcome, and if everyone thinks like this, what I'm coming to do over here?
But how could everyone think like that? Because you are here.
Exactly.
What has been the response?
Our response was good. I've been here, I'm now for the second time, so it means that I like it and it's good. Yeah. She will be attacked. She's just afraid about those kind of things.
Listen, this is not the only time that Africans outside Africa are coming. If you study the history, if you read it well, we have always wanted to be back. You see, these stories of they were sold, we betrayed them, a lot of it is coming from the white man who has never been truthful to what really happened.
Yeah.
If they were sold, they say that the number of Africans who died is over 200 million.
So,
over the span of whatever years, 200 or 300 years that they do, they did this evil. Those who were on the continent, who died from wherever they picked them, to the coast, also millions. So you are talking about over 300 million Africans whose lives were lost. Now this is the 16th century. So had this not happened, Africa probably would be 10 billion people by now. So can you see the damage that this thing has done to Africa? So if somebody says that you're not welcome, who told you? It's the same heritage. I was in school in Europe. And my friend who was a Brazilian, said that he went to Italy to pick citizenship because his great-great-grandfather was an Italian.
Yeah, Italian.
Yes, and therefore he proved that and they gave him the citizenship. My friend, in school, he told me this.
Brazilian,
yes.
Italian.
Yes, he took
you
that.
See?
So why, he can say that, but Africans can't say the same thing. How is that possible?
How is this possible?
So it's never true. So, and then there's a lot of wrong stories that they have really pushed and people have really believed it. Until you study Africa intentionally, you never know Africa.
Exactly.
Even if you live here. So that's why somebody can make such a wrong statement.
Yeah.
Who told you that they are not welcome? Go to the presidency and see. Go to any of our chiefs and see. If they will say, don't come. And as a matter of fact, our grandparents, they know.
Yeah.
Or they knew that
you will come. Yeah. And this is also what I said. I said that, you know, it's a divine intervention right now, and there is nothing that can stop this movement.
No.
And in 5 years or 10 years, we will see what the movement was what it is.
Yeah.
But for now, just come because it's not one person can't decide.
No.
Two persons can't decide. No. There are more than a billion people living in Africa. If there needs to be a decision, everyone needs to make it.
Who could make that decision?
No one.
Officially in the AU, they have a whole region that represents the diaspora. Nobody can. I don't know how ignorant people could be. Nobody can stop anything. Nobody can. All these great Africans, they have always come here. Look at even the those in America. The boss was here. He was a friend to Nkrumah, I think. They lived here, he died here. There is the Bo Center, go and look for it. There is a lot of data. There are so many African Americans living here who have lived here for years. Nobody, how can you tell? This is something that, this was an interception in Africa's growth. And it's, nothing has broken Africa more than this thing.
Yeah.
We just don't understand the story. We just don't know. We just don't have much appreciation of the facts. So, you know, we can make.
But what can we say to those that feel like this?
Even Chinese come here.
But there are still people that really, really believe that Africa is poor. And
you see this one? It's the Africa Trade House. This is the common trade. You know, this package that they have signed now, the African Trade, the Common Customs Unit. This is the head office.
So nice.
World Trade Center. The World Trade Center Ghana one.
First National Bank. This is, how does this road, how does this call it?
This road? I don't know the name of it.
No, but this area. This area
is more of the National Theater. This is the National Theater area.
Nice building.
Yes. So they do a lot of these plays, big programs there. Musicians come to sing, you know.
Eat a cafe.
Yeah.
There's a lot here.
So much. This is Accra Central.
Oh, look at
Kara. We will pass through. We will pass through the. Let's see. I wanted us to pass through the President House. Where he is. Presidential Palace. Yes. The Jubilee House.
But does he live there or
yes,
not?
Yes. That's where he operates from.
Yeah, those who feel, what do you have to say
Which
to them?
Those who are saying they shouldn't come or those.
Those that are afraid to come.
They shouldn't be afraid.
Just come, eh?
Ghana is safe.
Yeah.
Ghana is safe, and anywhere you go, when you get to the airport, what do they tell you? Welcome.
Yeah, welcome.
That's it.
Just welcome.
That's it.
And you know what? When I was at the airport, I think there were like 3,000-4,000 people that arrived, minimal. Yeah, so it was really a lot.
No. If they tell you not to come, it's because it's systematic. They have never wanted you to come to be part of it.
Yeah.
Because our strength is in coming together.
But how can we come together?
Not every one of us should come together. No, I will not leave. I went to school in Ireland, did postgraduate in engineering. You know, I did engineering.